Welcome to episode 5 of Minecraft Legacy. This is Ruby. Wow, I'm having some FPS lag. In the last episode, we started the wall and got a tower up. And in this episode, I want to solve the issue of I hate swimming across the lagoon here. Hold on. I was just playing in 1.14 on the Undercraft realm, so my controls and my sound, now that I think about it, are gonna be wonky. That's better, that's a whole lot better. How much wood do I have? I used it all, of course I did. 22 planks. Okay, well that's not enough. So, start by chopping down some trees, I guess. In this episode, I'm just recycling what was planned for what I was supposed to do this episode when I was supposed to record it, when I was re-recording episode 4, where I actually used some of the stuff I wanted to get done this episode. Wow, my frames. Pardon me. Wonder what I'm loading. So what I want to do today is I want to get a big dock done in that leads from there to the fortress, so I have somewhere to walk that isn't the water, because it's fairly slow and I don't like that. And then if I have enough time, what I might also try to do is lay out some more buildings, get some plans going for that, and maybe outline the galleon that I mentioned in episode 3. Not gonna start digging any canals, but I think laying out a big boat sounds like fun. So let me just chop down the last couple of trees over here. And then I'll turn it all into planks and... Pardon me. And then I'll turn it all into planks and get started. Perfect. 64, 64, and then I'm gonna have 8. Just as planned. I need to keep that in my inventory or I'm going to forget what time it is and be out at night, even though that's really... Okay, maybe that's a bit more of an issue than I thought. My armor is not as durable as I thought it was going to be. I think I will start hiding through the night again, because I've just now noticed that as the armor's durability goes down, the amount of protection it gives seems to be going down as well. Hold on, let me line myself up. And there. So I'll just build a wonderful little dock here. It'll go one above the water. And then what I'll probably do later is modify it and bring it up a little, but right now, so I can get through here with boats, because boats are fairly easy in this version. Hello, Mr. Chicken. But for right now, just have enough space to walk that isn't the water, or around this edge will be a lovely addition to the lagoon. And who knows, I might actually- no, I'm gonna have to. I've just had an idea. I could always put some houses on the water. Like, houseboats and stuff. Not far on the water, but like, definitely aquatic. You know? Certainly not all on land. Might actually extend this out one wider in every direction, in both directions, because I'm thinking that even though it looks fairly nice for what it is, which is a long wooden thing, a long wooden path, it can be done better. I know it can. Bad at block placement today. What is with me? And then I have some stairs. Knock this back, and then I have some stairs in my house, which I will add to the end, so that it's easier to get up on. Okay, here we go. There's a dock. I'm going to light it up before I get spawns on here and blow it up. Because that's going to happen if I don't do this. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. I love. Oh, yeah. That's exactly what I want it to be. Okay. Now for part two of what I wanted to get done today, if I have enough cobblestone. If not, I will lay it out in like gravel in the lake. Okay, gravel and dirt it is. Because I have plenty of those. I'm gonna lay out some more buildings. Oh yeah. Oh, I don't have a lot of anything right now. Make some stone shovels, because I know I'm gonna need them. This iron one does not have a lot of durability left. So let's see. I do want to play with diagonals. I know this is an odd version to be playing with diagonals in, but you can do a lot of fun stuff with diagonals. Sometimes it can really take a, a village or a town that you build from one level to the next if you play with how diagonals can shift buildings. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna put a lovely little diagonal house here. Built incorrectly, and I can't tell where. Maybe here. Because of this. There it is. Yes, there'll be a house, a building, and then I'll put another one. This one will be straight because that was a hassle and a half. This one will go here. And it'll be one of those kind of half in the water, half out. I've built a perfect square again, dang it. Half in the house, or in the water, half out ones, and I'll go ahead and give it an intriguing shape. Make it look nifty, funky. Give it two rooms. Very obviously separate rooms. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna wait out the night. And then when it's morning, I'm gonna come back. And I'm gonna lay out a few more houses. And maybe I'll get some of my dirt and lay out the galleon. So, see you then. Okay, so it is just about daytime, which means it's time to go lay out. Okay, actually, no, they're burning. Yeah, it's time to go lay out a little more of the town. My sword isn't in my hotbar. That's a dumb thing to forget to do. I think I'll put a house or something next to mine, but also at an angle. I think the only houses that I'm gonna leave is straight up, like, this is a rectangle. Are going to be no, that's not big enough. Pardon me. Are gonna be these houses. Ones that I've put directly on angles. And then, what the hell I'll be an okay house. And then I want something a little circular here. But not too circular like I've just tried and gone and almost made. I should not have started with the side that's farther from the house that I've just blocked out. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Darn it. What does it mean making this house wrong? I wish I could anticipate the sizes of circles. I think that would help, but I can't, so I won't. Nice. Oh, now I understand how that trick works. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Oh my god, I wish I could quit screwing this. Thanks, FPS lag. That's the piece that I wanted to get rid of. Absolutely. Okay. Well, you know, nothing's unfixable. So I've just gone and fixed. Wow, FPS lag. Wish I knew what was causing that. Okay, well, there's a circle house. I want to leave this kind of open. And then I think I'm going to put a house kind of built in to the mountain here, which I am going to leave as a bit of a kind of regular squarish shape. In fact, I'm actually just going to kind of not even futz with that. It's gonna look like this, and I'm gonna dig it into the mountain a little. I can't hear the moms over there anymore, and I'm a little threatened by it. And then I want a house that's like directly on this specific diagonal. First try, look at the shape of this house. I love it. And then, I guess next episode, we'll maybe have another mining montage. That or the episode after, because next episode is a Saturday next episode is a Tuesday episode. This is the Saturday episode. So next episode, I probably will have a mining montage, just per the nature of I'm going to have the time to do a mining montage. Because I'm going to have 3 days between this episode and next episode. So especially if I start like recording in advance or anything. If I try and get ahead. Or at least to get the mining montage out of the way. I'm going to have plenty of time to stitch together a montage. So put another house over here. And then I think we'll be done blocking out houses for now. And you know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go block out the galleon. It's midday. I can walk over there and start making a shape. So for this galleon, I probably should have a reference image for when I actually build it. But for the shape, I know what galleons are shaped like. The bit that goes in the water, at the very least. Wooey, that's some FPS lag right there, right there. That's what I'm talking about. I can't wait till I go to a version where I know Optifine exists. That'll be so much fun. Because then I might actually be able to just play with shaders on. And if not, I'll be able to do shaders tours, which will be fun. Whoa. And I hope this isn't from me running OBS and Minecraft at the same time. It didn't do this before. Whoa, whoa, okay. Okay, okay. We'll have to knock out the sandbar there, but that'll actually make it a little easy to start the galleon. Or it probably won't be a galleon. I think I might do more of a Viking longship, just based on the size. Wow, the lag. The size of the area that I have. But let's get this started. I do think I'm gonna go with colored sails, even though I'm going to have to find a lot of flowers to do that. Just because I like color. And I mean, admittedly, that might be a bit of the fact that I've played in 1.13. Have been playing in 1.13, like, since it came out. But, you know, color's fun to build in. Color is really nice. I like building in color, and I have a lot of fun with it. Okay, so I think this will be the length of the bit that goes into the water. And then it's gonna have a nice pointed front. Taper it down. I'm gonna need to do some terraforming. That's gonna need to be knocked out pretty far back. Ooh, do I have a cove in here? Because if not, I might make one. Okay, I'm gonna turn that into a cove, and it's gonna be glorious. Copy that on the other side, and what I'll probably do is instead of trying to block it all out in dirt, maybe instead of spending all of my time doing mining montage stuff like that, I will spend a lot of time getting like a tree farm started. I kind of have an idea of what I would like to do for a tree farm. I just don't really have a way to execute it right now. But getting the base area for where I'm going to put it selected is probably pretty smart. I'm also not going to spoil what I'm going to do for it. Oh, that's not how that looks. I'm not going to spoil what I'm going to do for it. Because that's not something I want to do. Yeah, this looks like this. This looks like this, and then that's a two, and then this is one, two. That's a three. That's absolutely unacceptable. This is not quite looking like what I want it to look like, so I think, am I really gonna have to fill all this back in with water? I'm so glad water mechanics were changed. I mean, it's nighttime, but I think knocking this back all the way to, and then by one, yes. One more, so I get like two, will give me a shape that I think I'll be happy with. Yeah, that looks a lot better. So I'm gonna run back to my house. And then in between episodes, I'm going to go on a mining trip and try and get a bunch more iron and some more diamonds. So maybe I can start upgrading with things like diamond armor. That would be nice. Probably also gonna try and get more feathers. Or maybe try and get that mob farm started. Pardon me, I'm beeping. And then I'm also gonna try and get the area for my tree farm blocked out. And I might even go and start collecting materials for it, because I know I'm being absolutely kinda here, but I would like to do a lot of brick in my tree farm. I want it to be like the one brick building in my little world here. So ahead and cut this episode here. I didn't get as much done as I thought I might, but I've only been recording for 20 minutes. So, see y'all in the next episode. If you're part of the morning crew, I hope your day is going to be great. If you're part of the night crew, I hope your day's been great. If you're part of the afternoon crew, well, I hope your day's going just fine. I've been Ruby Robotic, and I'll see y'all next time.